but I let go out at the venue and pop bottles with my team. Young money to the
top. I'm about whatever, man. What they be talking about? They a million doesn't count. We the only thing that matters. Oh, so we do it how we do it. All up in your face, man. I hate to push you through it. I be up all night, whole crew's in here. Cause I don't really know who I'ma lose this year. Oh, man, I love my team. And I love my team. I would die for them. Oh.
The NCAA, Western Washington Athletics, and the Great Northwest Athletic Conference encourages good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial or ethnic comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. And fans, be sure to stop by the concession stand outside the entrance to Harrington Field today for refreshments. Grab a Gatorade, water, or a light snack. Thanks to our new dining partners, Chartwell's, for being here to support all fans at Western Washington University athletic events this season.
I be up all night, whole crew's in here. Cause I don't really know who I'ma lose this year. Oh, man, I love my team, and I love my team. I would die for them. Oh.
I'm the new Sinatra, and since I made it here, I can make it anywhere. Yeah, they love me everywhere. I used to cop in Harlem, all of my Dominicanos right there up on Broadway. Pulled me back to that McDonald's, took it to my stash spot, 560 Bay Street. Catch me in the kitchen like the Simmons with the pastry. Cruising down A Street, off-white Lexus, driving so slow, but BK is from Texas. Me, I'm out there Best Buy, home of that boy Biggie. Now I live on Billboard, and I put my boys with me. Say what up to Tata. Sipping my top, sitting courtside, Knicks and Nets give me high five. I be spiked out, I could trip a referee. Tell by my attitude that I'm most definitely. With my click though, welcome to the melon box. Corners where we selling Africa, we buy the home of the hip hop. Yellow cap, gypsy cap, dollar cap, holla back. For foreigners, it ain't fair, they act like they forgot how to act. 8 million stories out there in the naked. City is a pity, half of y'all won't make it. Me, I got a plug special, and I got it made. If Jesus paying LeBron, I'm paying Dwayne Wade. Three dice, CeeLo, three card Marley. Labor Day parade, rest in peace, Bob Marley. Curse me blinders, but they could say. step out of bounds quick. The sidelines is lined with casualties. You sip the life casually, then gradually become one. Don't fight the apple eve. Wanna be the in crowd. Now you're in style. And in the winter gets cold, in vogue with the skin out. City of sin is a pity on a whim. Good girls going bad. The city's filled with them. Mommy took a bus trip. Now she got a bust out. Everybody ride her just like a bus route. Hail Mary to the city, you're a virgin. And Jesus can't save you. Life starts when the church in. Came here for school, graduated to the highlight. Ball players, rap stars, addicted to the limelight. Empty and made, got you feeling like a champion. The city never sleeps, better slip you an ambient.
I was
just
Washington fans, and welcome to Robert S. Harrington Field on the campus of Western Washington University for today's Great Northwest Athletic Conference match featuring your defending national champions, the Western Washington Vikings, and the visiting St. Martin Saints. Prior to the start of today's 90-minute match, we will introduce the starting 11 for both teams. First, for the visiting Saints, their starting 11 is announced by head coach Derek Faulkner and assistant coaches Alex Pagonis, Lisa Ryan, and Stephen Searless. First for the Saints, the goalkeeper and captain, number 32, Flavia Burrell. Number 2, Peyton Asselton. Number 3, Rose Ivanis. Number 5, Maya Fleming. Number 8, Nora Melcher. Number 9, Inara Lopes. Number 20, Raven Mummy. Number 23, Taylor Copeland. Number 24, Jemine Diaba. Number 27, Aziz Buttar. And number 31, Sam Bailey. And your starting Saints. And now for the host of Western Washington, the Vikings head coach, Travis Cannell. Assistant coaches are Jamie Arthur, Yohad Lahoud-Zahner, and Alex McBeth. Your starting 11 today. First, the captain goalkeeper out of Squim. Number 28, Claire Henniger. A defender, a sophomore out of Westland, Oregon. Number 2, Asia Harding. A sophomore forward out of Renton. Number 3, Minji Rauch. In the midfield, a sophomore out of Shoreline. Number 4, Morgan Monolily. The senior defender out of Bellingham. Number 8, Jaden Wynn. In the midfield, a senior from Seattle. Number 9, Peyton Neal. A sophomore forward out of Pasco. Number 10, Claire Potter. A defender, a sophomore out of Portland, Oregon. Number 12, Emily Rice. A freshman forward out of Portland, number 13, Jane Hamira. In the midfield, a junior from Spokane, number 16, Grayson Crosby. And at defender, a freshman out of Woodinville, number 21, Olivia Connell. Fans, your starting Vikings. We would like to begin by acknowledging that we gather today on the ancestral homelands of the Coast Salish peoples who live in the Salish Sea Basin throughout the San Juan Islands and the North Cascades watershed from time immemorial. Please join us in expressing our deepest respect and gratitude for our indigenous neighbors, the Lummi Nation and the Nooksack Tribe, for their enduring care and protection of our shared lands and waterways. And now, fans, would you please rise, if able, and turn your attention to the flags to the right of the scoreboard for the playing of our national anthem.
Hello and welcome to Harrington Field. We're back for some Western Washington University women's soccer as the race for the GNAC regular season title is on. Final three games of the season. Today, Western Washington taking on the St. Martin Saints. Vikings coming into this match 7-1-3 in GNAC play. Second place in the GNAC table, just 1 point behind Seattle Pacific University, who come to town next week on Thursday to play the Vikings. St. Martin's 1-5-5 on the GNAC season, sitting in seventh in the GNAC table right now. For the Saints, this is a game they need to win to stay in contention and try to sneak into the postseason GNAC tournament hosted this year in Ellensburg. For Western Washington, what a streak they have been on. After an undefeated four-game road trip, they come back and post yet another shutout, their third consecutive shutout on Thursday, as they defeated Western Oregon, a strong Western Oregon team who are in the running themselves for a spot in the postseason. Over 200, almost 300 consecutive minutes without conceding a goal for these Western Washington Vikings. They're only conceding 0.7 goals per game this season. That leads the GNAC. They have 9 shutouts. That also leads the GNAC, and it's significant against the Saints side that has not scored more than once in any game this season besides against Evergreen State College. I've not scored more than one in a GNAC contest. I've not been scoring much at all, really, in conference play. 6 goals for them on the season in conference play. 1 goal in their last 4 games. This is a Saints offense that needs to get going, and in a tough spot here at Harrington Field against a stingy Vikings defense. So Western Washington will look to jump out to an early lead and hold on to it. This is a St. Martin's team that has picked up 3 draws in road games this year. They play pretty good defense, considering only about a goal per game. They picked up draws on the road against solid squads like Northwest Nazarene, Western Oregon. And they've played teams tough. They play a lot of low-scoring games, trying to see out results. First-year head coach Derek Faulkner got off to a good start this season, picking up first win of his tenure against Colorado Christian. And also picking up solid results against Western Washington at home. A draw earlier this season, last time these two teams met, broke a long winning streak for the Vikings against the Saints. This has historically been a lopsided matchup, but St. Martin's has surprised a few teams this year. A lot of work to do for the Vikings, but if they can keep that good defensive work up and put some of the back in the net, they should be on their way to yet another victory here at Harrington Field. We'll see what they can do today in front of the home crowd. Whistle goes from head referee Adam Sanchez, and we are off and running. Western in the dark blue, attacking from left to right on your screen. St. Martin's in the red, attacking from right to left. Minji Rauch plays it up to Morgan Monolilly. She's been red hot as of late. 4 goals in her last 4 games. Streaks into the box here. Tries to lift it far post. Didn't catch it cleanly. Went out for a goal kick. Saints goalkeeper Flavia Burrell will collect. Burrell made a handful of impressive saves in that 0-0 draw the Vikings and Saints played to in Lacey earlier on this season. That was during the early run of form the Vikings had, where they were just having trouble putting the ball in the back of the net, but that has gone away as of late. Their last game, just a 1-0 victory. Before that, 4-0 on the road against Central Washington, 3-1 against Montana State Billings in Montana, 2-1 against Simon Fraser. They've really found their goal-scoring stride just at the right time. St. Martin streaking the other way. They wanted a corner kick on that one, but it'll just be a goal kick, says Adam Sanchez. They're handing her out to take. Game on Thursday, unusual in the fact that Western Oregon actually matched Western Washington's shot total. Not something we're used to seeing here at Harrington Field. Definitely a back-and-forth game, but a Morgan Monolilly first-half winner was enough for the Vikings. Another great stalwart performance by this Vikings defense and by Captain Claire Henninger. Morgan Monolilly, good control near midfield. Jaden Wynn lifts it ahead. Claire Potter on it. Potter at the edge of the box. Cuts it around the defender into the middle. Minji Rauch on, has a shot. It's deflected and saved by Burrell. Burrell had to react to a deflection off the defender. Did well to hold on to it. Waiting for a possible rebound goal was the freshman Jane Hamira. So an early opportunity here in the first 3 minutes. Forces the first save of the match out of Burrell. Monolilly controls it once again. Vikings pushing early on here, trying to set the tone. St. Martin's not able to spring a counter there. Asia Harden to cut it out. Harden, another excellent season in her sophomore year. An Ironman player just piling on the minutes at center back. One of the best defenses you'll find in Division II, alongside freshman Olivia Connell. That one's thrown in. Emily Rice going to track that one down. It'll go for a corner kick. First of the match for the Saints. And for underdog team like the Saints, they're going to find goals. It's going to be off of set-piece opportunities like this. Leading scorer, you mean Biava, has had success in the air this year. Near post, and that one out all the way. Not good delivery. Leads to right to a goal kick for the Vikings. So first attacking opportunity. Averted without danger. Anninger blasts it to the near touchline. Jaden Wynn under it. Flicks it on. St. Martin's trying to build up near midfield. They'll get a throw in. Saints coming off a 1-3 loss on the road in Burnaby against Simon Fraser. One goal they scored there broke a four-game streak without scoring a goal, so they've got one in their last five. Grayson Crosby gets dispossessed in a dangerous area. Working ahead here are the Saints. The shot is blocked and cleared away by Harden. Melcher had the opportunity. Vikings got a foot in, though. Vikings looking a little bit exposed on the counterattack right now. Need to tighten up those lines. Emily Rice chasing after it. Now Peyton Neal. Neal shoulder to shoulder with the winger. It's going to earn a goal kick for the Vikings. Excuse me, that'll be a corner kick. Looks like it did go off Neal in the end. Panara lopes over to take the corner. Showed with the right foot, the outswinging corner. NNU, a team ranked near the bottom of the GNAC preseason poll, as this one sent right into the mix. Top of the box, shot there was taken by Melcher and blocked away for another corner kick. So first 5 minutes, SMU already with three corner kicks. Had three all-GNAC selections last year. None of them have played this year. Right into the middle. Monalili got a foot to it, and it's cleared away by Asia Harden. Only as far as Taylor Copeland. Copeland's pass is cut out by Emily Rice, but it's given right back. Move inside here. Nara Lopes gets it back out. Touch is too heavy. Neal takes it away. Potter gets it to Monalili. Vikings on the break, 4-on-4 here. Minji Rauch tries to curve a through ball in there. Monalili or Potter not in an advanced enough position to get there before Burrell. Burrell been splitting time this season with Ali Campagato, the senior goalkeeper. Burrell, the first-year transfer from D1 Cal State Bakersfield, also wearing the captain's armband today. Grayson Crosby, another D1 transfer, gets it up to Monalili. Her pass is cut out. Finding that opener will be key in this game against a defensive-minded St. Martin's team. We're only scoring about 0.6 goals per game, bottom of the GNAC in scoring. Just 9 goals all season for the Saints. The pass deflected by Neal. Crosby trying to win it. Couple red shirts there, but Grayson Crosby does come out with it. Hamira. Crafty freshman winger outside of the boot pass. Gets to Potter. Claire Potter's shot is blocked. Player blocked it, Lopes in a little bit of pain. We'll take a break to look at Lopes. Took that pass straight off the leg, shin from Potter. Point blank range, she'll get back up to her feet. Early on here, two shots for SMU, both of them blocked. And they're not forced to make a save yet. But good signs from the visitors. Familiar territory for Saints head coach Derek Faulkner, previously an assistant at Seattle Pacific University. Played plenty of great games here between two great rivals of the GNAC women's soccer history. Won a GNAC title here a couple of years back at Harrington against the Vikings. Saints controlled in the corner, put it into the box. No red shirts there though. Easily picked up by Haniger. Haniger, another excellent season here in her senior year, graduate student. Climbing the WW record book in career shutouts. Already the leader in goals against, just about half a goal against her per game in her Western Washington career. Very impressive numbers. Integral part of the Vikings' run to the national championship last season. Thrown into Potter, first touch is heavy though, goes out. Pass ahead, Monolili does well to get around one, putting it into the middle, Amira. Shielded off from the box, lays it off to Potter, looking for space to cross. Cuts it inside, sliding tackle, sends it out. Western Washington picks up the corner kick. Looks like it will be Grayson Crosby to take the corner kick. Crosby, a bit of a dead ball specialist for these Vikings, taking the penalties for them this year. She's 2 for 2 on the year from the spot. One of those coming in that last road trip. Out swinging corner, low to the near post. Burrell goes up and claims it. Vikings saw a lot of success on Thursday, just putting it right into the mix from the corners. But Burrell, standing at 5'10", having an easier job picking that out of the sky. Taylor Copeland moves ahead with it. Pass is deflected by Wynn, but right back to Copeland. Trying to streak through the Vikings' defense. Weak shot taken there by Melcher. Now lets it go out for a throw-in. Copeland to take the throw-in here. Options are Melcher and Fleming. All the way into the box. Tried to flick it in, and Connell got there to clear it out. Potter shielding off the defender, tried to pass it back. Minji Rauch had already started to make the run ahead, though, so it'll be a SMU throw. Maya Fleming, junior out of Redding, California, throws it in. Back by Wynn to Rauch. Tries to find Monolili. Vikings having some trouble breaking out right now. Visitors applying the pressure in the first 10 minutes. Buttar, now Ivanis, nutmeg on Peyton Neal there. And now Monolili takes it away, gets it to Neal, goes down, pass ahead to Claire Potter. Minji Rauch on her right. Rauch has the speed, through ball, tries to find her. Oh, that's a perfectly weighted ball from Claire Potter. Rauch tries to get around the defender, can't do it. Ball is won by Rose Ivanis. Usually that was Maya Fleming making the defensive effort there against Rauch. In the one-on-one, if Rauch had gotten around her, it would have been a straight to goal. Rauch picked up a goal on that road trip as well. It's proved her ability to curl it into the net. Tall task for wingers like Amira and Rauch trying to fill the shoes of some departing Vikings. Sarah Levente going down in preseason with a knee injury. That attacking dynamism that she provided is something the Vikings are trying to replicate all year. They seem to have finally found it. It's been working through their star striker, Monolili. Leads the team in scoring with 5 right now. Vikings spreading out the scoring, though. 8 players on the score sheet so far this season. eight players also on the score sheet for the Saints this year. Yamin Biava, only player on the team with more than one goal. She's got two. That included the game winner and their only GNAC win of the year. That was against Central Washington early in the season at home. Vikings are thanking Central Washington right now, who went into Interbay Stadium and fought to a 0-0 draw against Seattle Pacific. Bring the gap at the top of the GNAC table down to just one. Vikings trying to close it further here today. Grayson Crosby wins the duel against Lopes. Top of the box, trying to thread it in. Mona Lily's in space, shoots, and the flag is up. Pearl made the save anyway. Good idea there from Grayson Crosby. Mona Lily just made the run a step too early. Grayson Crosby, in her first year in blue and white, has been absolutely crucial to these Vikings in the midfield and build-up play, winning the ball back. Losing an excellent player in the midfield like Tara Zimmer, having a player like Grayson Crosby come in is just so crucial. Angie Ratch wins the ball back, now with Neal. Vikings will build from the back through Asia Harden. Emily Rice trying to break down the wing. Dispossessed for a second by Biava and out of bounds. Thrown ahead, Hamura earns a throw in further up the field. Thrown in towards Claire Potter. Back to Mona Lily. Mona Lily has a long shot all the way across goal. Over the head of Benji Rauch and wide of the post. She'll go up for a goal kick. This is one of four GNAC games happening today. Big ones to keep your eye on. This one in Seattle Pacific, hosting Northwest Nazarene at 4:30. That passes straight to Mona Lily. Saints win it back quickly, though. But now Peyton Neal ahead, has a shot of her own. It's saved by Burrow, bobbles it, and then takes it under control. We saw the goal against Western Oregon on Thursday was scored after a distribution error. It was picked up by Mona Lily, and a quick transition led to the goal. Can't give the Vikings those free opportunities, especially with players like Mona Lily on the field. Thrown in towards Claire Potter. Now back with Rice. And the last player back is Connell. Switching to the near side, Jaden Wynn. Win to Mona Lily. Jaden tries to get it in there for Hamira, but the pass was too close to the Saints defender. And they'll try to break out here. Slowed by Minji Rauch. Lopes only plays it back. Vikings press coming from Neal right now. Asselton gets the throw in. Excuse me, that looks like it'll be a throw-in for Western Washington. So the press from Neal was successful, winning possession back. Potter has the Saints penned in right now in their own corner. Asselton fighting for space. Rauch is there as well. Vikings get the throw-in near the corner flag. Just under 20 minutes gone. Back and forth to start things off at Vikings. Good streak of momentum right here. Playing in and around that St. Martin's box, forcing some saves out of Burrell. Potter gets it back to Jaden Wynn. Wynn lifts in the cross. Far post, up for the header was Neal. Couldn't make clean contact. Harden, calm under pressure, gets to Grayson Crosby. Ahead to Rauch. Feeds it through to Mona Lily in space, has a shot. It's in! Once again, Morgan Mona Lily opens things up. She cannot be stopped right now. 5 goals in 5 games for Morgan Montalili. And there's the opener the Vikings needed to get out on the right foot. It was a beautiful through ball into Montalili. She did the rest. Past the diving Burrell. Morgan Montalili already has one GNAC Offensive Player of the Week award, making her case for another. First half goals in both of the games so far on this homestand. Fourth shot of the game for the Vikings. Gives them the lead. After the slow goal scoring start we saw from Morgan Montalili this year, so good to see her back playing at the ability we know she can. SMU trying to answer quickly. They have numbers here. Top of the box, Mummy tries to put it back into the danger area, but Wynn clears the danger. Montalili now up to 6 goals on the season, extends her lead atop the Vikings scoring rankings. A beautiful touch there to get around one. Can't get around two, though. Hypata goes down, draws the foul. Head referee Adam Sanchez has been playing pretty detached from today, letting play go on, not blowing the whistle too much, which I personally do like to see. Wynn tries to find Potter, takes a spill. No foul. It'll be kept in bounds. Lifted ahead towards Fleming. Fleming pressed by Neal. And once again, Peyton Neal there on the press to win possession back. We've seen that a few times so far today. Thrown in towards Potter. She picked up her first goal of the season on that road trip in the 4-0 win against Central Washington. Last year's national championship hero. Grayson Crosby gets it to Amira. Amira tried to get it to Potter, but the pass was cut out by that Saints back line. Early cross in from Wynn. Montalili, collision there at the top of the box. That'll be a free kick, and we've seen Morgan Montalili put these in from this distance. She had a couple of free kick goals on that road trip, one from as far as 30 yards out. Montalili is alongside Emily Rice, standing over this free kick. Four-player wall for St. Martin's. Burrell directing traffic. Looks like it will be the right foot of Montalili towards goal and over. No troubling. Fluffy Burrell saw that going over all the way. Other games going on today in the GNAC. Western Oregon taking on Simon Fraser in Burnaby. That's a crucial matchup to see who will make it in to the GNAC tournament. SPU and Western Washington have already punched their tickets. A win or a draw today for the Vikings will guarantee a top 2 seed. Western looks well on their way towards that with the opening goal. Montalili on the ball again. Streaking forward, laying it off for Claire Potter. Potter in the box has a shot of her own wide left. Flag's also going to be up against Potter. So the task just gets steeper for St. Martin's, a team that has had their goal-scoring woes in the GNAC, going against the best defense in the GNAC in the fortress that is Harrington Field. Saints have never won a game at Harrington Field. Vikings with 14 wins at home against St. Martin's in the history. Saints at the edge of the box here, threatening, put it into the box. Connell with the header and Crosby with the controlled clearance. Now out to Mona Lilly. Vikings doing well of building out into the counter. The final pass to Potter didn't get there. Ball over the top, headed back by Harden. Crosby is dispossessed, but only for a second. Now Saints back on the ball. Batar into the middle. Player goes down, referee says get back up. And this time the whistle will be blown for a free kick right at the edge of the box. So see if St. Martin's can find a response in a direct set piece opportunity right at the corner of the box. Looks like it'll be Peyton Asselton alongside Yamin Biava. Biava, the leading goal scorer this year for the Saints. She can find her third here, would level things up. Three-player wall for the Vikings. And her little problem with sun in her eyes. It is Biava right against the wall. Back to Biava. And off the face of Potter there. A long shot is blocked and taken back by the Vikings. See if they can break in space. A roulette from Mona Lilly gets it ahead, and now it's cleared. Last player back was Taylor Copeland. Morgan Mona Lilly scoring a goal today and showing off the flair as well. If that come off, that would have been absolutely class touch. Vikings will take the free kick in their own half, though. Avoiding the danger on the set piece once again. Most dangerous opportunities for the Saints have come from dead ball situations so far. Four shots in the match for the visitors. St. Martin's haven't done too bad this year on getting the ball on net. 12 shots per game is around the middle of the GNAC. They look to break in transition here. Chipped over the top, Henninger is called out. And the shot in the end came from Batar, didn't strike it cleanly. She said there was a deflection, but Adam Sanchez pointing for the goal kick. Good move by Connell there, get around the press. Up to Rauch. Mona Lilly, body fake, tried to get it to Grayson Crosby. Himira has it now. Himira racing ahead. Potter on her right, times her run. Potter has a shot right at Burrell. Burrell called into action again. Sixth shot for the Vikings. Third time Burrell's had to make a stop. Going to see our first substitutions of the match here. It will be for the Vikings. Sophie Bearden-Croft coming into the game to replace Claire Potter. And alongside Mia Cairns comes in to replace Minji Rauch. Cairns and Bearden-Croft have both scored here at Harrington this season. Bearden-Croft a couple of game winners early on in the GNAC slate. A good aerial threat. Mia Cairns, freshman strikers, really found her stride on that road trip. She had a couple of goals. Also had the game winner early on in the home opener against a ranked Cal State LA squad. Cairns, yet another member of a strong freshman class, sustaining the success of this program that's been just so long in the making, just a decade really of dominance in the West region and in the GNAC. Vikings have yet to miss a GNAC tournament final. They've played in every single one of them, all 10. Looking to return this season in Ellensburg. They've gotten hot at the right time here at the tail end of the season. Certainly helped by the fact that they're going to be able to finish their GNAC season with four consecutive home games. And in a home ground like Harrington Field, that is a massive plus. Vikings win around 80% of the games they play here at Harrington. They've only lost a handful of times. Last one against Western Oregon last season, which was the last loss they sustained before going on that undefeated run all the way to the national championship. Visiting teams do not enjoy coming into the South Campus of Western Washington University to play the Vikings. One of the toughest tasks you can have. One away by Nick Cairns. Looks towards goal, now tries to get it up to Beardencroft. Pass was deflected off Montalili. Sent back in towards Beardencroft. Can't corral it. Taken away by SMU. St. Martin's a defensive-minded team under Derek Faulkner. Four-player back line. Now down a goal, though. This game goes on. They're going to have to move players further up the field, get more exposed at the back. Jaden Wynn wins it. Pass was intended for Cairns, but straight to the feet of Amin Biaba. Saints win it back near midfield. Pass ahead to Buttar is going to go straight to the feet of Asia Harden. Harden and Connell, the prototypical cover and stopper center back pairing. Harden cleaning up anything that goes over the top, and Connell providing the aerial dominance. Karen's battling for it. Thought she might have got a quarter out of it, but it went off her in the end. Goal kick, SMU. Visitors will have their first substitutions of the match. Alyssa Toogood comes in. And for the Vikings, a couple of changes. The veteran defender, Katie Watt, comes in alongside Micah Carr. So a couple of seniors on the field for the Vikings. One up at left wing and one back at right fullback. Katie Watt, an excellent leader on this team. Somebody who rarely puts a step wrong on defense. Vikings would not have had that national championship victory without the consistent play of Katie Watt last year. Another change for St. Martin's. It'll be Aliakoye, the junior forward out of Pasco. So SMU, different look at the top of the formation now. They try to break out with a throw in their own half. Watt heads it forward. Montalili tried to keep it in after another throw, though. Micah Carr on the left wing. A lot of speed, high work rate. Just puts pressure on the back line of any opponent she goes against. Foreign in the side of fullbacks around the GNAC. Seen her create plenty of chances this year. Still looking to get on the score sheet. Connell takes no chances. Boots it out for a throw. Beautiful Saturday afternoon here in Bellingham, Washington. Bit cold, but the sun is shining. Good crowd at Harrington Field. This one's lifted in, headed out by Connell. Neal doesn't let Anara Lopes by her. Another SMU throw. Under 15 minutes remaining in the half. Vikings have had more of the dangerous chances, but Saints have certainly had their own cracks at goal. This one's in the box and cleared away by Asia Harden, who was last player back. Flag is also up for offside. And R. Lopes, the offending party. Pass took an awkward bounce over the attempted touch of Beardencroft. Vikings now well under over 300 consecutive shutout minutes. Headed forward by Crosby, under it is Cairns, gets to Mona Lily. Still inbounds, controlled by Crosby. Looks to perhaps switch to Neal, but plays it back to Connell instead. Vikings knock it around the back, looking for a way ahead. Pass, miscommunication there between Connell and Watt, out for a SMU throw. Both teams making some more changes here. Abby Succi checks in, replacing Peyton Neal. Sierra Nice comes in for SMU. Succi, the sophomore midfielder out of San Clemente, California. She'll take over in that box-to-box midfield role. Peyton Neal with a great shift in the first 30 minutes of this game. A lot of takeaways in SMU's half. Succi, her first touch of the match is a ball to Micah Carr. Hard first touch from Carr. Burrell's forced out. It's blocked away by Beardencroft, chasing after it now. Foot race between the goalkeeper and Beardencroft. Pops out again. Sliding tackle takes down Mona Lily. It was a clean one, though. And now play will be stopped as Burrell looks to be down in some pain. Not something you very often see, the race between the striker and the goalkeeper to get to a ball at the edge of the box. Certainly a clash between Burrell and Beardencroft. Hopefully the junior goalkeeper can get back to her feet here. Looked to have taken a knock up near the face. She is back up to her feet now. Restart with a drop ball controlled by the Saints. Credit as well to Maya Fleming, who put that sliding tackle on Mona Lily, denying her of an opportunity while the goal was open. Pass the feet of Mona Lily out for a throw. Draw between these two teams in Lacey earlier this season. First time since 2010 that a Vikings-Saints game hadn't ended in a Western Washington victory. That was back in 2010 when SMU notched a 2-1 win over WW. One of a couple bright spots here in this up and down first season for Derek Faulkner at the helm of this Saints program. Coming off a 3-win GNAC season last year, missed out on postseason play. Pass there from Connell is right to the feet of Inara Lopes. See if Saints can do something with that turnover. They get it to the wing. It's beyond the stride of Sierra Nice. And it's given away. Some more substitutions incoming. Morgan Mona Lily, the goal scorer, checks out to a round of applause. Coming in for Elisa Harmer, sophomore defender out of Bellevue. Palmer listed as a defender, but she's going to take a more advanced role, replacing Mona Lilly for these last 9 minutes. Alongside Bearden-Croft at the top of the Vikings formation. Bearden-Croft providing the height, Armour providing the speed. Bearden-Croft was one of the heroes in that Final Four last season down at Interbase Stadium. Scored in the national semifinal to send the Vikings through. They would, of course, win that final 2-1 against Westchester, win their second national championship in what was essentially a home game. Huge crowd of Viking fans, parents, alumni, just a great atmosphere. Great time for sports fans everywhere right now. World Series going on. Basketball, hockey season starting up. Both college and professional Viking basketball teams, men and women, getting their first preseason games in this week. Victories against Trinity Western and Bushnell. Shout out to Vikings cross country as well, sweeping the podium at the GNAC Championships up in Alaska. Ranked number one in the West region right now. Saints pressing ahead here through Copeland. Copeland had a little space on the wing, now guarded by Watt. Tried to get it inside to Lopes. First touch was too heavy and cleared away. Succi with her back to goal. Excuse me, that was Bearden-Croft being dispossessed. Gets back to Bearden-Croft. Cairns. Three red shirts around her. Very well done with the 1-2 between her and Harmer. Last pass wasn't there, though. Shots are 6-5 in this game, but dangerous opportunities have been for the Vikings. Claire Henninger not called on to make a save as of yet. On the south of campus with the sun shining into the eyes of Henninger, it might be a good thing that shots on goal haven't been coming for St. Martin's. No matter how good a goalkeeper you are, hard to beat the sun. Saints work it past Succi. Stopped up by Crosby, a long shot, and that will be the first save of the match for Claire Henninger, and it's about as easy as that'll get. Talked about it on Thursday. This is such a stingy Vikings defense. Sometimes the only opportunities you're going to get are those long shots. Just try to test the sure hands of Henninger. Cairns tried to play it ahead to Harmer. Pass was too heavy, taken away by Asselton. Asselton carrying it herself, now lifting it forward. Back to her counterpart, center back, Asia Harden. Lopes wins it back again. She's been strongly involved in build-up for the Saints in this first half. Part of that tough task of breaking down this Vikings D. Visitors haven't found success yet. Long ball ahead for Carter run on to, but all the way to Flavia Burrell. Burrell was a big reason that the Saints were able to hold that 0-0 victory at home against the Vikings earlier this season, making six saves. Harmer not able to bring it under her spell. Wins it back, though, gets it to Watt. Keep it up, Western! SMU throws ahead right to the feet of Harden. Taking off Hamira. Trying to get between the lines is Koye. Now put in the middle. Copeland was there, but Connell got there first. Something the Western Washington Vikings have been excellent at doing this year is playing up through those center backs. Calm under the press. Playing those little one-twos. Little fakes right there. Just to get it up near midfield. Abby Succi and Elisa Harmer forces the Saints all the way back into their own half with Asselton. Now Biava. I mean, Biava, center back as well as a leading scorer, not something you see every day. That one's put through into a dangerous area. Saints have a shot, and that's an excellent save by Claire Henninger with the leg. First save of the match for Henninger is a highlight reel stop on a one-on-one. Alyssa Toogood, the substitute, had the best chance of the night right there for St. Martin's. Henninger called into action. She delivers. It'll be a corner kick for the Saints. Sent near the mix and bouncing around in there and then cleared away by Hamira. Saints press forward again through Copeland. Pass is cut out by Cairns. Beardencroft, space ahead of her, lays it off to Harmer. Vikings will slow things down here, switch to the far end. Seeing a switch here, Katie Watt now on the left side, Hamira on the right in the fullback position. Grayson Crosby. Through ball, waited perfectly for Carr. Carr, one-on-one, has a shot rolling towards the line, and in! The first goal of the season for Micah Carr, doubles the Vikings' lead. A perfectly weighted through ball from Grayson Crosby finds the feet of Carr, who just got enough of it to get it past Burrell. Almost cleared off the line, but only into the side netting. It's 2-0 Vikings with 55 seconds on the clock here in the first half. Carr, the senior, first time on the score sheet this year. Speed kills, and Carr got to that one before the center back. Made her pay. So the hole gets deeper for SMU, a team that has not scored more than one goal against a Division II opponent this season. Has to score two just to draw even with Western Washington. We'll look to perhaps make this one comfortable. Time taken down here in the first half, though. What a change that is from 1-0 to 2-0. Vikings completely in control now going into the break. And that will do it for the first half of play. Morgan Montalili and Micah Carr make it a 2-0 advantage for the Vikings at the break. A convincing first 45 from the hosts. They are in the driver's seat as we go into the break. We'll be back in just about 15 minutes for the last 45 minutes of action here on Vikings TV. Please don't go away yet. I'm doing fraud, I got that bag on me, and I'm gonna transport. You know the mainstream thought I wouldn't be posted.
cash. Sell them all your records and we're making a dime. Oh, I'm buzzing.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Harrington Field. Western Washington University 2-0 up over St. Martin's at the break. Goals from Micah Carr and Morgan Monolilly giving the Vikings the control of this match as they try to secure a top two seed in the GNAC tournament, continue to put pressure on first place Seattle Pacific, only a point ahead of the Vikings right now. Going to play Northwest Nazarene 4:30 at Interbase Stadium, so the Vikings can see this one out. SPU will have to win to stay atop the GNAC. If they fail to win, Vikings back on top of the conference going into next week, Thursday, SPU versus Western Washington here at Harrington Field. Biggest game of the season, what could maybe be essentially a playoff for the regular season title in the GNAC between the two perennial favorites in the conference. But right now, Vikings just trying to do their end of it, finish off these last 45 against the visiting Saints. It was a first half that was back and forth more than you'd expect. St. Martin certainly with possession in the final third. Vikings, though, 7 shots, 2 goals, just using their opportunities well. A great finish from Morgan Monolilly. Another one by Micah Carr on the one-on-one off a perfectly placed pass from Grayson Crosby. 2 assists in that first half for Crosby. Impressive distribution from the transfer out of Georgia State. Crosby now up to 3 assists on the season. 7 points for her, has her 2nd in points for the Vikings. Minji Rauch also picking up an assist on that first goal. Put the through ball into Monolilly that she finished off. Rauch, 2nd assist of the season. She's up to 6 points on the year. Really just a good all-around half on the attacking end for the Vikings. And as always, the defense standing strong. Over 300 consecutive shutout minutes. 45 more would secure a win. This is an SMU team that have not scored more than once against a Division II opponent in any game this season. They've got to get at least 2 to knot things up at Harrington, the toughest place you can go to try to score a goal against a Vikings defense that's only conceding about 0.7 goals per game this year. SMU only scoring 0.6 goals per game themselves, so a very tall task for the visitors in these last 45 minutes. Couple changes for Western Washington coming out of the break. Claire Potter, Minji Rauch back on the field. 2 starters for this match came out around halfway through that first half. Back on to start the 2nd period of play. Sam Bailey stands over the ball ready to kick off for St. Martin's. Adam Sanchez blows the whistle and we're underway for the last 45. St. Martin's in the red going from left to right on your screen. Western Washington, dark blue, going from right to left. Immediately a pass deflected by Succi. Potter lays it off to Rauch. Rauch has the speed to get ahead here. Slows it up now. Turning with it, still on the ball. Gets it back to Potter. In the corner now is Jaden Wynn. Her delivery is low in the box to Carr. Touched it. Succi tipped just over the bar. Succi and Rauch both went for that one. Looks like it was Rauch who got contact with it, turning around, took a touch off a defender just over the crossbar. Flavi Burrell had it covered, but it will be a corner kick for the Vikings here in the first minute of the second half. Grayson Crosby already 2 assists in this match. Over to take the corner. The outswinger from Crosby. Near post. Cairns got a touch on it. Out for a goal kick. Cairns with a couple goals on that road trip. All of a sudden, 2nd leading scorer for the Vikings this year. She's got 3 behind Monolilly's 6. 5 of those 6 have come in her last 5 games. A brace against Simon Fraser in a 2-1 win. Goal against Central Washington. And then 2 goals in the first 2 games of this homestand. She had the game winner on Thursday against Western Oregon. As it stands, her goal would be the game winner today if the Vikings are not to concede. Wynn moves ahead with it. Fancy footwork to get some space for herself. Get it to Rauch. Carr touches it back, trying to get it to Claire Potter. Just not quite there. Vikings immediately threatening to put up their 3rd goal of the game in the first couple minutes of this half. Vikings yet to score more than twice in a game at home this year. Trying to change it right here with Rauch in the middle now with Carr. And cleared away. Havoc being wreaked by the Vikings down that right wing right now. Minji Rauch and Claire Potter causing trouble for the SMU fullbacks. Getting into the danger area. Yet to lead to a save from Burrell, but the opportunities have been there. Thrown in towards the freshman Cairns. Cairns gets it off to Carr, trying to control it, still pressing, gets it to Claire Potter. Potter with her back to goal. Nice move to get around two defenders. Can't get by the third, though. She will. Looks like get a free kick just at the edge of the box, though. Suchi and Rice over to take this one. Bit of a mock corner. Still a little bit of room to put it direct if they would like to, though. So Burrell has to be mindful of the shot. Creating space in the box for a header. Two-player wall. It will be Suchi on the deck, into the middle, cleared away. Toogood was there. Excuse me, that was Peyton Asselton making the clearance. Carr breaks towards the end line. Her cross is blocked, gets right back to her, though. Lays it off to Rauch. Rauch, curling shot. That one's going wide right. Pressure abound in the first 5 minutes of this half on the goal of Flavia Burrell. Taken away yet again by the Vikings. Potter doing the dirty work that time. Gets it back to her. Potter lays it off to Cairns. Cairns looks towards goal. Now back with it on her right foot into the middle over the head of Potter and Rauch, who are in the middle. Potter chasing after it. She might try to keep this one in bounds. It will stay in bounds for Potter. She gets it right back into the box and she's dispossessed now. Taylor Copeland tracking back to get it. The first 5 minutes of this second half have been played almost entirely in the attacking third for the Vikings. A lot of it in the box of Flavia Burrell and the Saints. Rauch tries to get it to Potter. Pass is just a little bit off, though. SMU looking to break out for their first time in the half. They will not do it as Rice gets back. And it'll be a Western Washington throw-in. SMU yet to get across the halfway line. Cairns heads it over to Micah Carr, goes down, no whistle. Crosby wins it back. Feeds it into Rauch. Three red shirts around her, turns and has a shot blocked. Lines are finally cleared beyond midfield. Last player back is Asia Harden. Henninger, the goalkeeper, calling for it. Give it right back to Harden. Vikings now up to 10 shots on the game. Potter tried the through ball there. Suchi trying to get to it. Excuse me, that's Mia Cairns. Applies the pressure and gets a throw in. That pass just beyond the reach of Carr. Ivanis tried to send it downfield for Aziz Batar. Strikers for SMU today have been isolated at the top of the formation. Not a lot of service getting into that final third for the visitors. One good save was needed out of Claire Henninger in that first half, denying Alyssa Toogood of what would have been the equalizer. A great save with the leg. And a one-on-one. Cairns clears her lines. as far as you mean Biava. Asselton pressed by Potter. Potter wins it back. Vikings looking to counter here. Claire Potter showing the pace on the break. Now shouldered off the ball by Asselton. That one beyond Batar. Elsewhere in the GNAC today, Western Oregon and Simon Fraser. They just started the second half. Western Oregon up 2-0 in Burnaby, and it is a crucial game for both of those teams trying to get themselves into the GNAC tournament in Ellensburg. And another team fighting for a spot in the tournament just outside right now, MSUB, picking up a win against Central Washington, 1-0 in Billings. Mia Cairns there winning the ball in the Saints' half, then winning a free kick. So it's looking like a race to the finish here, both for qualification for the GNAC tournament as well as that top spot. Western Washington, great position right now to keep that pressure on SPU, who have had an excellent season, still undefeated in GNAC play at 7-0-4. Vikings and Falcons played to a draw in Seattle at Interbay Stadium earlier this season. A Morgan Monolilly goal and a missed penalty led to that. SMU, a couple numbers here on the counterattack. Quick break ahead. Katie Watts right there to snuff it out, and a sliding tackle from Crosby as well, but the Saints still with it. Near corner now, Ivanis. Ivanis on the deck, away by Succi. Kept in top of the area. First possession in the attacking third of the second half for the Saints, and it's taken away by Cairns. Potter making the run ahead. The service comes from Cairns. Potter's got Rauch on her left. Gets it back to Minji Rauch. Pass a little bit behind her. Has to slow up for it. Has a long shot. Not troubling Burrell. It was a dangerous two-on-one opportunity with Rauch and Potter, but the return pass from Potter just took Rauch out of stride. Abby Succi, back to Rice. Rice ahead to Potter, back to goal. Dinked over the top by Cairns. Potter wants to put it in the middle, spinning, keeping possession of it. Play still going, playing on the ground. Can't maintain possession. Western Washington throw in. Claire Potter in the second half has had a huge impact on the game. A lot of the play has been going through her and Minji Rauch. Gets back to Cairns now. SMU trying to break out of this high press. Carr's going to take it right away. Potter cuts it towards the end line. Now back. Top of the box for Cairns. Cairns making space for the shot, blocked away on a dive. Rauch on it now. Rauch a shot of her own, saved by Burrell. The header from Wynn, tipped up on the line. Stays out from Carr. What a reaction save from Flavia Burrell to deny the point-blank header from Jaden Wynn, as well as the shot from Minji Rauch. Incredible that that one did not cross the line for the Vikings' third of the game. Saints hold on. Best opportunity of the second half goes to begging for the Vikings. Carr waiting on the line, almost had her second of the match, second of the season. Harden back to Rice, the fullback. gets it up. She's got Carr ahead of her. Towards the middle. Cairns is making the run. Didn't get all the way there, though. Succi now tries to feed it through. That one's cleared away by the center back, Jameen Biava. Center backs and Asselson, Biava, and Bailey have had their hands full in this second half to work here again against Cairns. Deflected cross, and looks like that one's going to be called for going over the line before the cross came in, so it'll be a goal kick. Cairns just not able to get there quite quick enough. Vikings, a red-hot team right now. Undefeated since September 30th against Western Oregon. That's 7 consecutive games, 6 wins, 1 draw. Looking to make it 7 wins and 1 draw in their last 8 here today. Lifted ahead, Rauch showing the speed, trying to get there, sliding in. That'll draw a foul on a very aggressive sliding challenge by Rauch. No card. Down on the play is Biava. For this game, Vikings had not conceded in 3 games. 1-0 win against Western Oregon, 4-0 against Central Washington, a 0-0 draw on the road against Northwest Nazarene. Have not conceded 2 goals in a GNAC game this season. Only loss was that 1-0 mark against Western Oregon in Monmouth. Vikings avenged that one on Thursday, winning 1-0 at home against the Wolves. Perhaps a preview of a GNAC tournament game this season, as Western Oregon putting themselves in a very good position for qualification with their win today. Perhaps against Simon Fraser, as they do hold a lead in Burnaby. Burrell pressed by Potter, clears it away. Headed up by Rice and controlled by Ivanis. Gets it around Rice. Ivanis charging over midfield herself. Trying to find space near the wing, but that one's sliding tackle by Grayson Crosby. Still with the Saints, though. Over the top, trying to find Melcher. Melcher guarded by Watt, deflected, shot. Unable to be kept in bounds by Haniger. It will be a corner kick for the Saints, their first of the half. Red shirts at the top of the box, now making their runs in. Right into the mix, headed up, edge of the box. Shot is blocked away by Claire Potter. And now Micah Carr starts the breakout. Gets it across midfield, but Potter will not be able to get there in time. So Claire Potter, the striker, gets back to make a block off the set piece and stop that opportunity. Succi 1-2 with Carr ends up out of bounds for a Saints throw. Ten Vikings now have scored a goal this season, spreading the wealth on the attacking end as Carr had her first goal of the year in the dying embers of that first half. Potter pressured by Ivanis, keeps possession and switches play over to Jaden Wynn. A reset back to the center back, Harden. busy week in athletics here at Western Washington University. The Western Oregon doubleheader on Thursday, ending in a draw and a win. This one's put over the top. Potter won't get there. Later tonight, Western Washington volleyball continues their push towards the end of the season against Simon Fraser at Carver Gym. I'll be on the call alongside Zen Hill for that game. Hope you can tune in. First changes of the half for the Vikings. Two dangerous attacking threats onto the field with Morgan Monalili and Beardencroft. Monalili has what would be, as it stands, the game-winning goal in this one. Open things up with about 20 minutes gone in the first half. Beardencroft already with two game winners at Harrington this year. Put in by Cairns. Other side of the box. Monalili can't bring it down cleanly on the second touch. Vikings will have a throw-in with Wynn on the far end. Thrown into Cairns. Her attempted cross is blocked by Asselton and out for another Vikings throw. Simon Fraser in Burnaby against Western Oregon getting a goal back. So now 2-1 Wolves in that match between the third and fourth place teams in the GNAC. Cairns on the deck into the middle. Clear to the top of the box. Nara Lopes heavily involved in that first half. Hasn't had many touches here in the second, though. Pass from Harden is beyond Emily Rice. SMU trying to get it going quickly the other way with the throw. They earn another throw in further down the field. Only shot of the half was blocked at the top of the box by Claire Potter following a corner. This one's thrown all the way into the box. Flicked in. Scramble in it. Henniger diving down on the deck, and Katie Watt, the tackle with the goal open. That's as good as a goal line clearance right there. Batar had it at the feet, ready to finish it off as Henniger had dived beyond it, but Watt made the tackle, sent it out for just a corner. Sent right into the mix. Top of the box. Shot is taken on the deck. Blocked away. Second shot is wide right. Henniger was a spectator to that one. Peyton Neal and Olivia Connell, two starters, re-enter the match. They'll replace Katie Watt. Watt saves the goal. Comes off to a round of applause. Neal had an excellent first half. Big part of the Vikings' high press, winning the ball back in the Saints' half a number of times, keeping the pressure on that led to that first goal. And the center back pairing of Connell and Harden, which has become the norm for Travis Connell this year. It's been effective as any in the GNAC, just 0.7 goals against the Vikings per game this year. Working on three consecutive shutouts, over 300 consecutive shutout minutes. 24 minutes away from their fourth consecutive shutout. Neal feeds it to Carr on the near end. In the corner, one-on-one with the defender, cuts it towards the end line. Service into the middle is blocked. Beardencroft gets there, though, turns and sends it towards Cairns just over her head. Would have been a point-blank header for Cairns if she was able to get up to it, but just a bit too high. And it'll be a line change for St. Martin's. Five subs. I'll try my best to keep track of who's coming on the pitch here. Morgan Wetzel, Laiakoye, Sierra Nice as well. Maya Foster getting her first minutes of the game. Freshman forward out of Port Orchard, Washington. She'll slot into the right wing, working against the fullback, Emily Rice. Ball goes that way. Flicked up towards Rice. Controls it and gets it to Beardencroft. Beardencroft tried to feed it back to Rice. Did not make the run. SMU at 10 shots on the game now. Double digits for both teams in the shot column. Saints averaging around 12 per game this year. But in this lack of goals they've had over this last run, it's been difficult. One goal in their last five games. That's one goal over their last 21 shots on goal. Breaking head here is Mona Lilly going down, and that'll be a yellow card. Easy decision by Adam Sanchez to penalize Peyton Asselton, taking away the transition opportunity from Mona Lilly. That one goal on 19 shots on goal, similar to what we saw earlier this year from the Vikings, who just seemed like there was a wall in front of the goal. They kept putting it on net, but never in the net. But they have broken out of that slump in a big way. They're one of the hottest teams in the GNAC right now, scoring second in the GNAC in scoring as it stands. Service from Harden. It's dangerous. Flicked on by Neal. Top of the box. Grayson Crosby. Beardencroft. Back to goal. Two red shirts ahead of her. Crosses blocked right back to her. And Neal will send it in. Mona Lilly ahead to Cairns. The shot is blocked. Back to Mona Lilly. Shot of her own on the deck. Carr had a touch to it. Couldn't bring it down cleanly. Beardencroft tried to pounce on the rebound. Ended out for a throw-in. Ellie Busick coming into the game. Senior forward out of Happy Valley, Oregon, replacing the goal scorer, Carr. She'll come off to a round of applause. Busick early in the season here at Harrington was a great substitute piece for Travis Cannell, coming in, wreaking havoc on those fullbacks, running hard, creating her own opportunities. Yet to be on the goal scoring sheet this year, but she's certainly had her effect on matches. Win lifts it ahead. Fighting for it and winning it back there was Mia Cairns. And getting the throw in. Good work by Cairns. Applying the pressure to Asselton. Thought she could just shield her off and get the goal kick. Thrown in towards Cairns. Fighting for space, back to Wynn. Wynn will send the cross in, it's blocked. To the feet of Crosby. Cairns works out of a tight situation, back to Crosby. Cairns, good pass ahead, Beardencroft. All the way on the other side was Busick, didn't get there though. Neal, Rice is calling for it, it gets to her. Neal cuts it right. Dispossessed. Going the other way now. Zelia Koye. Coming together there. Looks like it took a deflection off the arm of Rosa Vanis. Vikings will take over with a free kick. See if they want to get players up into the box here. Look for the long delivery from Emily Rice. Rice will put it all the way into the box. Beardencroft is there, bouncing around towards Cairns. Has a shot, a great save. Scrambling for the rebound is Beardencroft and cleared away. Another highlight reel stop from Burrell. Denies Cairns on the turning shot. under 20 minutes left to play. Vikings in an excellent position right now to come up with another victory. Force SPU to win to stay atop the GNAC at 4:30 against Northwest Nazarene at Interbase Stadium. A draw or a loss would see the Vikings atop the GNAC table going into the last two games of the regular season as they try to defend their regular season title. Crosby, beautiful through ball, finds Busick in stride. Busick crosses deflected into the middle. Beardencroft turning, shots deflected and collected by Burrell. Vikings, 19 shots now in the match. They have been peppering the goal of Flavia Burrell, who stood tall, made four saves, and some of them very impressive. Connell takes it away, takes it towards midfield. Her service, that's going to find Busick. Busick cuts it inside, space on her right foot, has a shot of her own, curling over the crossbar. Burrell seemed confident in that one going over, but it was not too far off from Busick. Credit to the center back, Olivia Connell there. With a great ball over the top from midfield to find Busick in stride on the left wing. Saints moving ahead here on the left wing. Service up to the top of the box. Controlled by Connell. Calm under pressure. Gets it away. Over the top. Rice has to head it up in the air. Chase after it. She'll get a throw-in for her efforts. Excuse me, that will be an SMU throw-in. Last touch off of Emily Rice. Another line change for SMU. Four subs for the visitors. Batar back into the game. Mummy back in. Melcher alongside Anara Lopes. So head coach Derek Faulkner going back to just around what he started the game with. Some rest for his starters. Back in for these last 16 minutes as they try to find a couple of goals to tie things up. Tall task ahead of the Saints. Koye deflected off of Neal. Still in the danger area, now cleared by Harden. Beardencroft applying the pressure. Monolili got a touch to it, but took a tumble. Batar pressed by Connell. Batar is offside. Claire Henniger trying to pick up what would be her eighth shutout of the season. Continue to climb those shutout rankings in WWU history, securing her spot as one of the best goalkeepers to wear blue and white for the Vikings. Credit to her and credit to the defenders in front of her year in, year out. It's been as tough as they come. Nutmeg there, moving ahead by St. Martin's by Mummy, but it's taken away by Connell. Monolili across midfield. Space to run. Ahead past a couple defenders towards the back line, trying to feed it through to Beardencroft. Looks like that pass was deflected, though, into the arms of Burrell. Rice can only clear it out for a throw. Under 14 minutes remaining. Taking a shoulder to the back there is Grayson Crosby. Quick whistle from Adam Sanchez. Vikings will take the free kick. Western Oregon's extended their lead to 3-1 on the road against Simon Fraser. Looks like they're headed towards a big road win. Fancy footwork by Peyton Asselton gets it around Neal. Far side controlled by Yamin Biava. Now played back towards the box. Going down at the edge of the box is Biava. No whistle. They're calling for the ball into the middle. He gets there. Biava controls it off the chest. Flag is up. Biava's offside. And also looks to be in some pain on that right leg. Clock will stop at 12:41, so Biava can receive treatment. Biava back under her own power up on her feet. Saints leading scorer on the season. Not the player that Derek Faulkner wants to lose at this point in the match. Played a lot this game in a defensive center back role, but now moving far up the formation. Acting as more of a winger striker alongside Anara Lopes and Aziz Buttar. We saw earlier a four-player backline for the Saints, now just two. Numbers having to be pushed forward to try to find some equalizers. That one will be a Western Washington throw. See if the Vikings can find the gaps in this depleted defense now and extend their lead. Now entering number seven, Quinn Cassing, Katie Watt, and Abby Succi enter the field. Mia Cairns, Grayson Crosby, an excellent performance today with a couple assists. She comes off the pitch, as well as Jaden Wynn. Thrown ahead and flicked back. Cassing her first touch of the half. Unable to win it back. Mona Lilly still trying to get it back. A spin move there. Asselton gets it ahead. But one back by Neal. Harden on the near side to Emily Rice. Busick works it around to Vanis. Tried to find Cassing. Play is going to be called back here for a foul in the buildup. Adam Sanchez played the advantage. Advantage went away, blew the whistle, give the Vikings a free kick. Emily Rice over the top trying to find Morgan Monolili, headed back by Ivanis. Saints looking for a spark on the offensive end. A sliding tackle from Monolili, who's chopped down right at the midfield circle. Morgan, one of those crafty players that tends to take a beating from opposing players who slide for the ball and only find their feet. That time, taking a hard tackle on the slide. No hard feelings, though. Neal gets it into Cassing. Cassing at the top of the box. Busick's in space on the corner. Busick working it towards the top of the box on a nice run. Has a shot right into the arms of Burrell. Makes her fifth save of the night. Not the most difficult she's had to make. Passing back to Rice, breaking out of this SMU press. Can't do it this time, but a miscontrol gives the Vikings back the ball on the throw-in. They'll have another substitution here. Elisa Harmer replaces Morgan Monolilly. Less involved here in the second half than she was in the first, but her goal still stands as the game winner. Clinical strike on a through ball from Minji Rauch. Moved by Cassing. Gets it to Busick. Looks to switch the play across. Harmer trying to run onto that ball over the top. Katie Watt tracking all the way up, too. Neal wins it back in the SMU half. Spinning away from a few defenders. Gets it to Busick. Just beyond her. Smile on the face of Peyton Neal. That was a nice move to get around the pressure, but the end, the pass was just a little bit too far for Busick. Taylor Copeland checking back in his last 8 minutes. Harden back to the captain, Henninger. Clears it ahead towards Busick. Busick takes it across midfield. Rolls it behind her and tries to get it up to Beardencroft. Cleared back by Bailey. Vikings, an excellent job down the stretch here. Game management, controlling possession, not letting the Saints get even a sniff of goal. 7.5 more minutes to close out a win and a shutout too. Beardencroft can't get by Bailey that time. Neal still applying the pressure. We've seen that so many times today. Beardencroft goes down, draws a whistle. 30, 35 yards out here. Perhaps a little bit too far to try a direct free kick. Vikings will be in no hurry to take it as well. Succi and Busick stand over this one. Two-player wall for the Saints. It'll be just Succi now. On the deck, right at Favia Burrell. Tried to sneak it past the wall, but nobody got into the space in time. Copeland working against Peyton Neal. Cutting it towards the touchline. Her pass is taken away. Chloe Unflat onto the pitch now for the Vikings, getting her first touches of the match. Busick. Good ball. That's going to find Beardencroft. Offside, though. So Unflat now stepping in at left fullback to see out these last 5 minutes, 30 seconds. That ball ahead finds Aziz Buttar, the edge of the box, guarded by Harden. Harden, a great tackle on the one-on-one. And looks like that will be a corner kick for the Saints. Time running very thin for the Saints to get all the way back into this one, but they can at least deny the Vikings of the shutout, something that has been a difficult task as of late. 5 minutes away from their fourth consecutive shutout are the hosts. Lissa Tukud, who had the best chance of the match back in that first half for St. Martin's, denied by the leg of Claire Haniger. She's back on, replacing Buttar. She tracks to the near post. It's going to be sent there. Haniger up to claim it over the head of Toogood. Haniger hasn't been too busy today, but when her time has come, she has delivered. Attempted clear and takes a deflection off of Harmer, a second one as well. Suchi tries to play it up to Harmer, taken away by the Saints. Just beyond the reach of Ellie Busick, gets to the feet of Inara Lopes. Lopes against Busick, looking for options, cuts it towards the middle of the pitch. Can't get by Peyton Neal. Out for an SMU throw. Neal continues her excellent game in the midfield. Another change for the visitors. Sierra Nice coming back on. Third time this game that she's been brought onto the pitch. Perhaps the last here was just 3.5 minutes remaining. Nice's first touch off the bench is to the feet of Chloe on flat. Passed it out to Quinn Cassing. Busick touches around one defender. Tried to get it by Peyton Asselton, couldn't do it. Through the legs of Neal and going to the ground is Rosa Vanis. And that will be a yellow card for Peyton Neal on that tackle. First Viking to go into the pocketbook of Adam Sanchez. Inara Lopes will take this free kick, try to curl it into the area. Clock stopped at 3 minutes, 11 seconds. You got to think if the Saints are going to get all the way back into this one, they need a goal, perhaps right here on this set piece. Opportunities have been tough to come by. That one right towards the head of Asia Harden. Top of the box now. Ivanis. Back to Lopes. Lopes keeps it in bounds. Gets it by Unflat. Gets it by Neal as well. Now Neal does win it. SMU take over with another throw in. Flicked on by Unflat into the arms of Claire Henninger. Henninger boots it across midfield towards Harmer. Can't keep it in bounds. Vikings 2 minutes away from going atop the GNAC table for the first time this season, at least until the 4:30 matchup between Northwest Nazarene and SPU. Connell heads that one away. Vikings have gone back into a low block looking to see out the shutout. Crossed over, Unflat is there on the header to flick it out towards the top of the box. Neal. Two Saints around her. Gets it to Cassing. Now to Busick. Vikings have numbers here. 4-on-2 on the counterattack. Busick. Harmer's making the run. Busick going herself. Busick into the area. Shoots it straight at Flavia Burrell. A great run from Ellie Busick. The shot just too close to the goalkeeper. Unflat ahead to clear it further into SMU territory. 1 minute remaining. Connell chases down this attempted through ball, gets it back to Henninger. Line drive from Henninger, finds the feet of Suchi. Saints get it to Lopes. Lopes lays it off. Long shot's blocked in there by Connell. And another great game for the freshman center back, Olivia Connell. Saints still trying to deny the Vikings that shutout, knocking on the door, and they're going to have a very dangerous set piece here just at the edge of the box. With 10 seconds on the clock, they're going to have to hurry up. This will be a buzzer beater. Just a two-player wall for the Vikings, sent over the crossbar, and that'll end it. Western Washington, 2-0 victors over the visiting St. Martin Saints, and they go atop the GNAC table for the first time this season. They are now 2 points ahead of Seattle Pacific University, who will take on Northwest Nazarene at 4:30 in Seattle. If Seattle Pacific doesn't win that game, Western Washington will be on top of the table going into the last two games of the season. We hope you can make it down next Thursday or tune in on Vikings TV, where the Falcons take on the Vikings in the biggest game of the season. We'll have the coverage here. But Morgan Monolili, Micah Carr, the goal scorers, another shutout for the Vikings, their fourth consecutive, 10th of the season. Great defensive showing once again from these Vikings at Harrington. They go away with the victory. We'll be back next week. And tune in later tonight on Viking TV. The Western Washington Vikings volleyball team takes on Simon Fraser at Carver Gym. I'll see you there from this afternoon. 2-0 victory for Western Washington. I've been Adam Race on Viking TV. Thank you for tuning in. Good afternoon. And as always, SCOVA.